Serve time!
Maybe gonna require some of Ogre's help to even secure that bottom lane.
Looks to make his move in.
He is going to be standing,
now looking for a turnaround play. In this case, he comes down. He strikes it and takes down LT.
Bottom lane, Q is just trying to go for a D ward. They're gonna make the chase for him. No forgiving slash, but looks like maybe straight to the pit, looking around all the way. That'll be your first initiation, first duel victory. Empire. Burning wants the last hit.
Heroes that are supposed to save.
Waiting. Right. Kinetic field is possible. Q stepped in, but that's when Empire killed himself.
Oh,
But, yeah.
Okay.
So different type of damage. They've got two types of heals now.
For the old man right now and take him out. But they're hoping for a lead in roll or just a lead in easy magic missile. Wave rolling boulder. That should be your first blood. Easy setup in that ward. Bottom is still being overrun by Empire members here. In fact,
they know that Empire is going for this, so they ping them out because they saw them rotating with the ward.
Do they want to rotate anyone in? I don't think so. Get out of here! Heal, and he just gets all of his life back, and you just suddenly you're sent back into the next dimension under a Reaper sight.
Mid lane,
deep commitment, going for the Coddle, and they connect him with Rolling Boulder with the Boulder Smash. The finish is going to be there from Iposhka. Rotation's in, though, from IG. They did struggle with in the first game. Now,
as long as
Ward
the supports are moving,
OP has been spotted. They'll roll right in for him. And that man has been seriously mugged, but no, he's able to get the jump and out
to the enemy safe lane, but we'll see, maybe this rushes it.
Lead in roll. Cold Embrace going to help not get the finish there, and they couldn't get it done. It's going to be Iposhka going down first. This is an Empire lead in gank, and they can't get a grab yet.
The map, TP the Slaughter to another, and just can't be able to make moves all over the place. And Empire's lineup is a bit, their mobility is lacking because they have a death Necron. This is just going to be pickoffs that are going to happen every...
Here for IG. Empire continuing to grind away in the farm, but they continue to get hit here. A jump in now, looking for Chappie. Toss out the Decrep. Here comes Assistant Ghostchick trying to be the paramedic, but he's not going to be able to assist him. Chappie going down.
And it's them making all the aggressive moves. Empire can't really make... speaking of aggression, Empire now goes for one of their first moves.
Let's see how it goes. Swap back to set up a magic missile. Can they finally bring down the Wyvern? Yes, they can. It takes three of them.
It's just gonna happen. One of them is gonna get picked off here. And here we go. Coming in, it's gonna be Iposhka. Just get brought down in an instant.
How
going for two,
you?
Though. King R going into OP with the Bloodstones, leading up the charge.
Empire want to try to fight this one off, but they've already been hit so hard. That side, not gonna do so much.
Oh my god.
Avenger shreds right through the Necrophos. Oh my. Q happy about that one. Ghostchick Force back. FN, does he really want to waddle back in there? He does. A new blast is going out. He's trying to go for the finish. They hit him with a mana leak. A new blast flies through. He just pops the borrowed time. They give him a new shield. They're looking to go for the finish. He pops out the ulti. He's looking to burst him down. Can he get it done? They blast him
burning
back.
Against the
burning.
Aegis. And he gets the last hit.
He sticks in and gets the last hit and the extra life. Look at Chappie.
He
stuck
got
on the high ground.
Blinding lighted on the high ground, I believe.
And OP goes in right up there to get the finish. IG all day here. Ahead of the opposing top laners.
Oh, scan coming out. They do miss on the crush for FN, but here we go. Burning's in.
He thinks he's manning up against a Slardar, but then Burning pops out, and suddenly FN just goes full man mode and just wipes out his extra life. But then OP steps in to make it a more fair fight, and he quickly gets a hold of FN and just takes him right out of the picture. A double kill for OP.
And so they should be aware that a move might be happening here.
Rolling in is going to be Iposhka looking to cut someone off. They've spotted Q. He gets off the Glimmer Cape. And they're just going to have to let the old man go down. IG thought about stack burning here for XXS as he just beelines it. Now he gets off a nice boulder smash, but he ends up rolling right into him. So, of course, Roche to just below half of his life. There goes Troll looking to commit the call. Are we going to see a fly-in? There goes the blast, lead and crush. OP not going to go inside the pit yet, but they are going to be able to blast them back and away. Will IG stay and fight, or will they turn and run? Lockdown on the Slardar, not quite enough to go for the finish. Burning pops out, looks to isolate the Wyvern ulti, will help get the finish. Now he goes for the next target, unstoppable for OP as he finishes off another. Now has no more mana to work with. A chomp of the cheese, an Empire step away here. They take their Roche and they get to hold on.
They don't look like they're done.
Oh no! IG continue to chase, get a wonderful crush, and now look to go for Ghostchick, who has to turn their attention away from the rest of Empire.
Oh, he gets his minus off before he dies.
Force out a buyback. If the one was available here, a swap is forced out. But now Burning looking to move in. They blindly land him back and they get the finish. Q gone. 2-0 from Empire here. And what could be for the final hurrah of the upper bracket? They get the Silence Grip with the Cold Embrace. They keep an OP alive, man. They can't get him down. He's able to run back out and step away from trouble. Extra life. They feel there's blood in the water, and they want to go for the finish. Do they jump to the high ground? They do! Beautiful two-man catch right there from IG! And they're going to look to go for a third. Ghostchick gets off the borrowed time, but they are slowly looking to walk him home. Iposhka tries to help him out with the stun, but now they set him up as a sweet treat for later as they move in for the icy dessert. They get it done. IG, a recipe. They remove it. Long jump in, and it's a spirit-on-spirit hate crime here. Here. looking to stay alive, but they slide on in, looking to go for the Necro. A long swap save does come out, but they will get the quick burst finish onto Q. The buyback going to be forced there. Troll looking to move in, isolates, targets down, burn it, getting dump them down, they can! With the help of the Scythe, they will get it done. They will get their own fire back, though, finishing off the secondary support, but credit to Empire. Keeper Ward scouts him, and look at Q, old man Q, he's like, I'll lead off the charge. Moves in, tries to go for a D-Ward, but that's when Chappie jumps in, that's when OP jumps to the back lines. Moves in, gets the quick finish, taking out the Earth Spirit, now he could be focused. He pops his BKB and steps back, but they find a swap target.
Nice blinding light.
For Boboka, they separate with the blinding light, and that's when they initiate. Look at the go for FN, and they get it with the burning bomb. Troll goes down, follow-up's gonna be there for Chappie, and they have no Troll or Chappie buyback. This looks to be in,
oh,
and
it is over!
Empire to the lower bracket. IG managed to get it in game number three. 30
Bloodstone charges. OP just going out of control in this game.